We need to start this session with an important health warning that we all have very different experiences of our fathers here on earth. Some people in the group will draw wonderful inspiration from that relationship. Others will not want to share things which are personal and painful. So let's be careful with each other during this session before we carry on. So let's start by taking in this collection of Bible verses put together some time ago in a beautiful way to describe God's Father heart to us as if it was a love letter.
The words you are about to experience are true. They will change your life if you let them. For they come from the very heart of God. He loves you, and He is the Father you have been looking for all your life. This is His love letter to you. My child, you may not know me, but I know everything about you. I know when you sit down and when you rise up. I am familiar with all your ways. Even the very hairs on your head are numbered, for you were made in my image. In me you live and move and have your being. For you are my offspring. I knew you even before you were conceived. I chose you when I planned creation. You were not a mistake, for all your days are written in my book. I determined the exact time of your birth and where you would live. You are fearfully and wonderfully made. I knit you together in your mother's womb and brought you forth on the day you were born. I have been misrepresented by those who don't know me. I am not distant and angry, but am the complete expression of love. And it is my desire to lavish my love on you, simply because you are my child and I am your father. I offer you more than your earthly father ever could, for I am the perfect father. Every good gift that you receive comes from my hand, for I am your provider and I meet all your needs. My plan for your future has always been filled with hope, because I love you with an everlasting love. My thoughts toward you are countless as the sand on the seashore, and I rejoice over you with singing. I will never stop doing good to you, for you are my treasured possession. I desire to establish you with all my heart and all my soul, and I want to show you great and marvelous things. If you seek me with all your heart, you will find me. Delight in me, and I will give you the desires of your heart, for it is I who gave you those desires. I am able to do more for you than you could possibly imagine, for I am your greatest encourager. I am also the Father who comforts you in all your troubles. When you are brokenhearted, I am close to you. As a shepherd carries a lamb, I have carried you close to my heart. One day, I will wipe away every tear from your eyes, and I'll take away all the pain you have suffered on this earth. I am your Father, and I love you even as I love my Son Jesus. For in Jesus, my love for you is revealed. He is the exact representation of my being. He came to demonstrate that I am for you, not against you. and to tell you that I am not counting your sins. Jesus died so that you and I could be reconciled. His death was the ultimate expression of my love for you. I gave up everything I love that I might gain your love. If you receive the gift of my Son Jesus, you receive me. And nothing will ever separate you from my love again. Come home and I'll throw the biggest party heaven has ever seen. I have always been Father, and will always be Father. My question is, will you be my child? I am waiting for you. Love, your Dad. Almighty God.
Here are two testimonies from Christian worship leaders who had very different experiences of their own fathers to help us to begin to understand this relationship with our Father in Heaven through our relationship with fathers here on earth.
Carl Tuttle, an American pastor who came from a broken home, had a very unhappy childhood in which his father abused him. After Carl became a Christian, on one occasion, he particularly wanted to hear what God was saying to him. He decided to go out into the country where he could pray for a whole day without being interrupted. He arrived at a secluded spot and began to pray. But after 15 minutes, he felt he was getting nowhere. So he drove home again, feeling very depressed and disappointed. He told his wife that he was going upstairs to see his two-month-old son, Zachary. He went into the room and picked Zachary up. As he was holding the baby, he felt an incredible love welling up within him for this little boy, and he started crying and talking to him.
Zachary, I love you. I love you with all my heart. No matter what happens in this life, I will never harm you. I'll always protect you. I'll always be your father. I'll always be your friend. I'll always care for you. I'll always nurture you, and I'll do this no matter what sins you commit, no matter what you do, and no matter whether you turn from me or from God.
Suddenly, Carl sensed that he was in God's arms and that God was saying, Carl, you're my son and I love you. No matter what you do, no matter where you go, I'll always care for you. I'll always provide for you. I'll always guide you.
Prepare yourselves to talk to each other about what we can learn about God as Father from our experience of fathers on earth by listening to Matt Redman's inspired, beautiful worship song about God, our Heavenly Father.
Listen to a thousand tongues, but there is one that sounds above them all. The Father's song, the Father's love, you sung it over me and for eternity. It's written on my heart. Heaven's perfect melody, the Creator's symphony, you are singing over me. The Father's song. Heaven's perfect mystery, the King of Love has sent for me, and now you're singing over me, the Father's song. so many songs, listen to a thousand tongues, but there is one that sounds above them all, sounds above them all. The Father's song, the Father's love, you sung it over me and for eternity. It's written on my heart. Heaven's perfect melody, the Creator's symphony, you are singing over me, the Father's song. Heaven's perfect mystery, the King of love has sent for me, and now you're singing over me, the Father's song. Of love has sent for me, and now you're singing over me, the Father's song, the Father's song, the Father's love, you sung it over me and for eternity. It's written on my heart. It's written on my heart. You sing it over me, Father.
So how much of our experience of fathers on earth can help us understand God as Father? Let's take another view of God as Father by looking at his frustration through his prophet to the people of Israel, which reveals at the same time his heart as a father to them.
When Israel was a child, I loved him, and out of Egypt I called my son. But the more they were called, the more they went away from me. They sacrificed to the Baals and they burned incense to images. It was I who taught Ephraim to walk, taking them by the arms. But they did not realize it was I who healed them. I led them with cords of human kindness, with ties of love. To them, I was like one who lifts a little child to the cheek, and I bent down to feed them. Will they not return to Egypt, and will not Assyria rule over them because they refuse to repent? Swords will flash in their cities, will destroy the bars of their gates, and put an end to their plans. My people are determined to turn from me, even though they call me God Most High. I will by no means exalt them. How can I give you up, Ephraim? How can I hand you over, Israel? How can I treat you like Admah? How can I make you like Zeboim? My heart is changed within me. All my compassion is aroused. I will not carry out my fierce anger, nor will I devastate Ephraim again. For I am God, and not a human being, the Holy One among you. I will not come against their cities.
Does this image of God's relationship with the people of Israel help us to understand God as our Heavenly Father? This time we're going to look at the relationship that Jesus had with his Father in heaven, as described in the Gospel stories, to see whether that can help us create a model of the way that God should be Father to us. So remembering that Jesus was brought up with Joseph the carpenter as a father, does Jesus' relationship with his Father in heaven help us to understand God as our Father in heaven? finish by writing down descriptions of our experience of God as Father, and then thank Him for being who He is to us.